evening, everyone. Good evening, everyone. I'd like to give a special welcome to Mrs. Pitts, Mr. Weeks, and the rest of the Board of Trustees, honored guests, teachers, family, and friends. As I stand here before you all with this geometrically shaped hat and cat-like toy hanging from it, I am honored to welcome you all to the commencement ceremony of the class of 2017, baby. I also want to give a big thanks to each and every one of you. Thank you for putting up with us through the years. I know we weren't the most well-behaved class, and we definitely weren't the quietest class. I mean, have any of you heard Mackenzie Miller's laugh? Behind me are 38 students, including myself, 39. Sorry for showing off my extensive math skills that GDS has provided for me. And we will be graduating here soon enough. Yes, I said it. We will be graduating, so I'm sorry if you lost that bet. On behalf of my classmates, we would like to thank our parents. You guys put us through Glades Day, and it is because of you guys that myself and each and every one of the students behind me can call each other family, because that's what we are. A slightly large and mostly happy family. We've all been thinking about this moment since the day we entered GDS. We sat in class for countless hours, wondering if this day would ever come. Then senior year arrived, and we all did exactly what Kenny Chesney told us not to do. To quote Mr. Chesney, don't blink. We all blinked. It feels like it was just the beginning of the school year. We all pumped up that it was our last year, but now all I can think about is the last 2 weeks when we just moped around class, waiting for the May 5th when we would be done with school. We all joked around saying, woo, it's our last first day of school, our last first this, but then it was our last homecoming, then our last football game, then our last field day, our last prom, and then it was our last day, our final day of high school. And as I give this speech, I'm reminded of this memory, it just keeps floating up, of the first time I watched Batman, the very first time. So my mom and I were sitting there on the couch, and when the movie was over, I jumped up off the couch and I said, Mom, when I grow up, I want to be Batman. And she looked at me and said, Jonathan, you better grow up. You're graduating in 2 weeks. To my class, boys and girls, we made it. I've been waiting so long to say that, and it feels so amazing to say that. I've known most of you for a very long time, and there's very few of you that I have not known for such a long time, but nonetheless, over this course of our high school, we've grown very close together, and I want you guys to remember one thing. Remember where you came from, your home here at Glades Day School, and never forget the memories we made and the mark we left on her grounds. So before you venture out onto your next chapter of your life, take a look all around you, all those faces that love and care about you and want to see you go into the world and make a change. Remember, because they always say life throws something at you. So remember, when life throws something at you, just catch it and throw it right back at life and say, what'd I tell you about throwing stuff at me? So now, parents, guardians, friends, family, would you please turn in your Bible to John chapter 11, verse 35, and the scripture says, Jesus wept. Even now, close your Bibles. The reason I incorporated this verse into my speech is because as myself and all the rest of this greatness receive our diplomas and leave this gymnasium, we're going out into the world to leave our marks once again, but this time on new grounds. But on my final note, and on a serious note, I'm going to be reading from Romans chapter 8, verses 38 and 39. The verses read, for I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from God's love that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. In saying this, class of 2017, as you pursue your path in your next chapter of life, remember this. There is nothing at all that can separate you from God. Trust in His plan for you. Keep your faith strong and always, always love God. I love all y'all. Thank you.
I turned on the evening news, saw an old man being interviewed, turning 102 today. They asked him what's the secret to life. He looked up from his old pipe, laughed and said, all I can say is, don't blink. Just like that, you're 6 years old and you take a nap, and you wake up and you're 25, then your high school sweetheart becomes your wife. Don't blink, you just might miss your babies growing like mine did, turning into moms and dads. Next thing you know, you better have a 50 years is there in bed. And you pray and God takes you instead. Trust me, friend, 100 years goes faster than you think. So don't blink. Well, I was glued to my TV when it looked like he looked at me and said, best start putting first things first. Cause when your hourglass runs out of sand, you can't flip it over and start again. Take every breath God gives you for what it's worth. Don't blink. Just like that, you're 6 years old and you take a nap, and you wake up and you're 25, then your high school sweetheart becomes your wife. Don't blink, you just might miss your babies growing like mine did, turning into moms and dads. Next thing you know, you better have a 50 years is there in bed, and you pray and God takes you instead. Trust me, friend, 100 years goes faster than you think. So don't blink. So I've been trying to slow it down, I've been trying to take it in, in this here today gone tomorrow world we're living. Don't blink. Just like that, you're 6 years old and you take a nap, and you wake up and you're 25, then your high school sweetheart becomes your wife. Don't blink. You just might miss.